to get closer to you. Now, anyone who reads this for the first time would think that he is teaching a commandment of hatred, but instead, he is teaching about the cost of following him. It's not about hatred. It's about you putting everything to him, giving it to him, to where you, it won't be about you no more. It's about what we must be prepared to do to follow him. It's about giving up our own lives and everything that we love, the family, friends, whatever it is, in order to get to him and to get everything that he has for us. But he gives us free will just to see, you know, where our faith is and if we're gonna actually follow him or continue to walk with the world. Think about what he did with Abraham and Isaac. He commanded Abraham to go and sacrifice his son, someone who was dear and near to his heart and loved very much, but Abraham did it. He went and he was going to do it, but an angel of God came down and said, I now know where your faith is and that you fear God. Are you willing to step out on faith like Abraham and sacrifice something that you love very much in order to get everything that God has for you, for your life, and for everything that's going to happen in the future? Now, that can mean an abundance of rain. I know y'all haven't heard that message before. That means blessings, breakthroughs, burdens lifted up, multiplication of what you have. 1 Corinthians 14:40 tells us that everything has to be done in decency and in order. So there's an order to follow God. You can't just say that, oh, I profess God and I love God with all my heart, but yet you're still over here doing whatever you was doing before you profess that. We can't be lukewarm. We gotta get rid of some things. Why? Because it costs to follow. We have to count the cost. Just like it says here in verse 28. We have to count the cost. Meaning, is it worth it by keeping it or letting it go? If we keep it, is it gonna cost us our eternity? Or if we let it go, is it gonna give us our eternity? We want God and everything about him until we realize it's going to cost us something. It's going to cost us our friends, sometimes even family. Because there's often times where your family can be your biggest enemies. The ones who pray for your downfall. The ones who don't want to see you doing good in life. They don't want to see you come up because they want to be better than you.